Hey, how are you? Welcome to beer review number 14, 13, 15, I don't know, I lost count. It's been a couple of weeks since the last one. I haven't been really in the mood for a drink, and just got back from a visit with my parents, who are both in their 70s, and they live out up in not far from Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. And so my wife and my son, we headed out there. Just got back earlier today, before this recording. And so I wasn't sure what to do when I got back, doing a lot of, you know, creative stuff, as you probably have noticed. So I wanted to do just a video like this without the pretense of a big elaborate production and binaural microphones and a million different objects going on and all that, and just do a down-to-earth, no-frills, keeping it real, beer review, and then we're going to talk a little bit about music. Just keep it simple. K-I-S-S. Keep it simple, stupid. I like to keep things stupid. I like to keep things stupid. I do. I like to keep things stupid. I like to keep things simple. I don't like to do, you know, where I'm doing... I may be elaborate as far as costumes to a degree, but when I do my videos, I like to do what I can without all the extra stuff. I'm a big proponent of less is more. But yeah, so we're gonna check out a beer, enjoy a beer, and just chat about music. Something less heady for a little bit, something that we can all probably relate to. I would have liked to have done this live with a Google Hangout, but I wasn't really quite happy with the audio of those Hangouts. And my cable, I have RCN, and I don't think the upload data rate is that good. So I didn't want to risk going through the pains of all that for the audio quality not to come out. Now I could simply record that and record, you know, with my normal equipment, but then it just takes extra time to render that video and upload it, and kind of defeats the purpose of the whole live event. The whole live event is to record everything without having to do all this production, so to speak. That's my take on it. And yeah, I also have a P.O. box, and I have some more items for my next giveaway. For those of you who are 18 years or older, I'm going to be giving away, I'm not sure if it's to three people again or one person. I haven't really decided yet. I didn't even decide what the giveaway is going to be about. I have an inkling. So first up, we have Tool's CD Enema. Anima, however you want to pronounce it. This and their CD, or their album, Undertow, are my two favorites. Just because I'm more of a... I don't know how to put it, but those particular albums, I like all kinds of music, and we'll get into that in a little bit. But I like more my music filled with angst, but not because I'm angry. I just like that emotional power in music. I like their other works, you know, 10,000 Days and Lateralus, etc. And I love Pucifer, and I love A Perfect Circle. But Tool, for some reason, to me, is Enema and Undertow. It's just, I love those two albums, and I know the band themselves, you know, they've grown and matured or whatever, and, you know, maybe have moved on emotionally and things like that from the angst that was kind of in these two albums. But I'm giving away Undertow and, you know, Pucifer and stuff later, giveaways. But I wanted to start with this first, so that's one. Bill Hicks, live. It's a one night stand from the Old Vic Theater in Chicago. Relentless. His performance at the Montreal Comedy Festival. The one night stand's 30 minutes. Relentless is 70 minutes. And Revelations from the Dominion Theater in London, 75 minutes. Plus a bonus documentary, Just a Ride. So this is the first official worldwide DVD release of Bill Hicks Live. Captures Bill at his very best with three of his legendary filmed performances. I have yet to see this myself. This is, of course, sealed. And a huge, big Bill Hicks fan. I love Bill Hicks. Everything he says. He was ahead of his time, and it's a shame that he died so young, in his mid-30s. Amazing, amazing person. Funny as hell. Great stuff. And, Eraserhead, by David Lynch. Unfortunately, I think this is in Korean, because when I purchased it, I think it was like $10. I didn't even know it was the Korean version. It has subtitles. It plays on US DVD players. Apparently, the US version is like $30. It's hard to find. I didn't know that. So I hate to give this away because it's not just the American version, but I know I don't have just American viewers, and maybe that really doesn't matter too much. So, I'm going to give it away, and hopefully someone will be happy with that who's never seen it. So, these are going to be the three giveaways next. Just have to figure out what the giveaway is going to be about. Like I said, I have a P.O. box. And you'll find the P.O. box in the description of this video. You know, everybody always points down, like, where else would the description be? Hey, look at the description of the video. So if you... The main reason I opened up that P.O. box, and yes, this is a beer review, so we're going to get the beer in a minute. The main reason I opened up the P.O. box is so that I could have a return address when I mail these giveaways. And because I want to open up for anyone that wants to mail postcards or letters. And I would show them online here in a video. I want to do like a weekly or bi-weekly mailbag video, where I go to the P.O. box and I pull out whatever letters and stuff people send me. Now, I want to say right here, right now, that I'm not looking for gifts. I'm not looking for freebies at all. Please, don't send me anything like that. You may feel you want to, and I don't want to take away from, you know, whatever goodwill that you're trying to do, and I appreciate that. But I'm not looking for freebies. I'm looking for beer. I'm not looking for anything. I can't stop anyone from sending that stuff to me. But I want to make it known right now. Now, if you send me something, and this is going to be also on the description, I just can't accept random boxes from people that I don't know what it's coming from or what's in it. So if you're going to send me something in a box, something besides a letter or a postcard, let me know that you're sending me something in a box and let me know who it's coming from. Now, if you feel like you want to send me, I'm very nostalgic and I love letters and I love postcards. I love to see postcards from all over the world. So if you ever happen to be somewhere and you pick up a postcard and you want to send it to me, I'll show it online. And what I want to do is I want to create this big, I don't know, 11 by 14 poster size thing of postcards from around the world, maybe a year from now or 2 years from now. Maybe put that up for auction and maybe donate it to charity, right? That'd be awesome. And of course I would, you know, use Sharpie black magic marker to mark out the addresses and names. And just the front of the postcard, the back would be glued to the board or poster board or whatever I'm going to glue them to. That's one idea. And of course, if you want to send me a letter, you have something to say, you want to vent, you want to tell me about your ASMR experiences, you know, feel free. Send the letter in, and I'll read it right here, and I'll give you your little, because I know when somebody does something for me personal, you know, it kind of heightens the ASMR experience. So I want to kind of do that to you, Freudian slip there, if you know what I mean. So send me a postcard and I'll be like, you know, hey, check this out. I got this postcard from Poland from YouTube user, you know, blah, blah, blah. And if you want to give your first name or just your initials, you don't have to give me your last name. Just use your last name initial, especially in your return address. Don't worry, you know, I'm not going to do anything with addresses. I already mailed 3 giveaways to people. You know, it's, everything's cool. But I won't read anything, you know, your real address in the video for the world, so don't worry about that. So, you know, we'll go from here. So, all right, so let's get on to the beer review. I have here a beer from Poland. The first thing I want to say, I really wanted to drop some names, mention some names of some YouTube users, viewers, subscribers that have suggested names of beers, of various international beers. Unfortunately, the beer garden that I go to, they only carry about 20 or so international beers. And I looked for some of the ones that you've mentioned, and they didn't have them. So it's going to be like a hit or miss if you, I try my best, you know, to look for the ones that you've suggested, but they don't always seem to carry them. So I just had to do a random sampling of what they had. And this is one of them. This is TYSKIE. And I want to say, because I'm a stupid American, I want to say Tyski Bear, right? But that's not, I'm sure it's probably Tyski or Tyskiv. I can't imagine how it's pronounced. I probably should look it up online, but my phone is dead and I'm too lazy to turn on the computer for the internet. Dang internets. So if anyone out there is Polish, and I'm part Polish, and I don't even know how to speak Polish, let me know. But it says, for now I'm going to say Tyski. I don't know. Maybe I even shouldn't say it. Tyski Browary. Made in Poland. Tyski 1629. And down here it says Gronie. Gronie. No idea what that means. Looks like it won some awards. The Brewing Industry Grand Prix International Awards. London 2002 and Munchen, Munchen 2005. Product of Poland. Imported by Tyski Browary. KSIAZECE. Washington, D.C. Premium lager beer. And just again, it says Tyski Browary Kiazetsi. Again, it's that K-S-I-A-Z-E-C-E. And then these, if you see right here, my camera's not good. You see that? K-S-I-A, the A and the E have these curls underneath of them. And the Z has a dot over it, so it's got a, something with pronunciation, I'm sure. I'm just butchering it at this point. I'm not even going to embarrass myself any further. 5.6% ABV, alcohol by volume. Made in Poland. There's the back of the label. Nothing much else there. And there's the bottle cap. Yeah, so let's get this open. And let's get my little Lager Pilsner bottle here, and let's just try to get this see the carbonation. Doesn't really have much head retention. That's not really important to me. Some people, when they do beer reviews, you know, like I said, I'm still somewhat of a novice when it comes to beer reviews, but it's got a nice golden lager color to it. Not much different than what you see on the camera. Nice strong lager aroma. I guess you would say that yeast aroma. Again, I'm no expert. Smells good. Let's give it a taste. Smooth. It's not very bitter. It's almost like a smooth yet crisp and clean. Ah, that's nice. That's a good beer. It's a nice lager. The beer's been sitting out for about 20 minutes. So it's 70, it's about 70 degrees in here. So I'd say it's probably about temperature of this beer is probably 50 degrees, something like that. It was kept in the refrigerator, of course, so it wasn't kept warm. So I like my beer warm, cold, doesn't matter. I prefer it not too cold, though. I'll give it 3 stars, you know, it's nothing stand out. Nice typical lager. Nice clean taste. Smooth. What else to say? So, definitely recommend it though. I would drink it again if it was available, you know. Wouldn't go out of my way to get it. So, good beer. Beer, good. So yeah, music. So where do we start? Well, I don't know what kind of music you like, but let me start way back how I got into music, and then I think it's probably the best way. Just we can cover what I feel is going to be a wide variety of music. So I was a child of the 70s, and my parents had some 45s, LPs. They had Chuck Berry, My dad liked big band music. But that wasn't really too much of an influence on me. I loved Chuck Berry. It was a great album. They had the Monster Mash. The Monster Mash. It was a graveyard smash. The Monster Mash. Chuck Berry. Jeez. Wasn't that song? God, is that the right song? I don't know. I can't even. Anyway. Johnny Be Good. Johnny Be Good. Johnny Be Good. That was a good song. It's Chuck Berry, right? Johnny Be Good. They also had my parents, Catholic. Not very strict to a degree. You couldn't curse, things like that. But they weren't, you know, had to read the Bible or anything like that. My dad more so than my mom. With that being said, they had a George Carlin album that I could never listen to, and it was like, I remember like finding it hidden somewhat, and it was a George Carlin's album where he talks about the god Fred, something like that, and I never knew who this George Carlin was, and it was until years later that I, you know, in my 20s that I found out who George Carlin was. I was like, wow, my parents had George Carlin. And they didn't want me to curse, you know? What kind of double standard household was I growing up in? But it's all good. Ah, yummy. Music. So they had those. My oldest brother had 8-track, and he had Pink Floyd, The Wall, Blondie, Cars, this band called X, The Clash. Man, great stuff, man. So he was probably the first person that influenced me, turned me on to music. Because it wasn't long after I found out about his 8-tracks and that I found out music for myself. And that was, the very first albums were, I remember going into the record store and pulling out Van Halen's 1984 with Jump, with the baby, with the angel wings, smoking the cigarette. That was a fucking awesome album, man. That album was amazing. I don't really care for Van Halen stuff prior to that. I still don't. But to me, Van Halen is 1984. You know, I'm just not a diehard Van Halen fan. I like them for that album. That's about it. Great album. And then Michael Jackson's Thriller. I purchased that album. I don't really remember when, but Thriller, again, to me, that's Michael Jackson. That was an amazing album. Every song on that album is just amazing. And Michael Jackson is just an amazing person. Maybe he had some issues and problems. You know, show me an artist that doesn't. Show me a person that doesn't. We all have our issues. We all have black and white, night and day, you know. But Michael Jackson was just, it was a shame what happened to him. He would have been around today, just this mega, like this idol, if he was just, could have just figured some stuff out and somebody helped them or something. I mean, I guess it was just, you know, it is what it was. It is what it was. It was what it is. How about that? You know, it is what it is. You know, that's how things turn out. But, you know, he seemed like a, there was a good person in him. But Michael Jackson, the Thriller album was just amazing, man. You know, Billie Jean, Thriller, of course. I can't even remember all the songs in that. So that was some of the first bands that I got into, that I heard about. And then, I really can't remember much after that, but then in high school, I found out about Metallica. Man, I'll never forget getting this Metallica CD. I didn't even know who these people were. I just had the Ride the Lightning cassette, you know, the electric chair, and the lightning on the cover, and it's blue. And in my mind, I've never seen heavy metal artists before. And all I could think of was these big burly guys with denim jackets, like bad biker dudes, man. I just had this weird preconception of what heavy metal guys were, you know, because heavy metal was like, oh, it's bad, it's bikers, it's evil, it's Satan, you know, and I had all that mixed up in my mind. But man, I was blown away by Ride the Lightning, and I was like, wow, what the fuck is this? Heavy metal, this is fucking amazing. And I just wanted more, man. So I went from Ride the Lightning and Master of Puppets. And then I from there, it was just when I went to find every heavy metal artist that I could find. I mean, Nuclear Assault, Death Row, Slayer, Anthrax, SOD, Testament. I mean, I was watching MTV Headbangers Ball, and I went down to the Tower Theater in South Street in Philadelphia, and Tower Theater was just this forever standing monument to music, so to speak. And I would go through their albums looking for just to, you know how you want to find out the more obscure artists because you know that no one else is listening to them, right? They're not as popular, so it's just like, just like this ASMR thing, right? Or just like, I don't know, just like any comic book or any kind of medium, you sink your talons into and your fangs, and then you're looking for obscure people to find because you don't want to do whatever else, excuse me, you don't want to listen or watch or read what everyone else is reading, for the most part. I mean, at least I'm like that. Like I said, I found Death Row, and I found, you know, Nuclear Assault, and now Holy Terror. Man, there's Fate's Warning. They were okay. You know, Slayer, of course. And then Metallica was just, Metallica for me became my religion. And just real quick, we're going to get into faith, spirituality and religion in one of these videos. But that's a problem with religion. Religion is not just faith. Religion can be anything. Religion can be pro sports. You've seen the people where they're so pro their favorite team and they have merchandise and that's all they talk about. I mean, that focus, religion is when you worship, to me, is when you focus your life onto any one thing and it becomes your world. You know, whether it is religion, faith, Catholicism, you know, Wicca, Satanism, you know, Buddhism, or whether it's a music artist, or I don't know, anything. To me, you're the ultimate way to live, the best way to live as a human being, is to just not focus on anything and try to have as diverse interests and not follow anyone or anything. Appreciate everything, you know, and all that. You know, I don't want to get too much on a tangent about that stuff here, but so Metallica, I had posters. I would get the Circus magazine, and I would get Metal Edge magazine, and I would cut out Metallica articles and put them on my wall. It was like Metallica's shrine. And then my first Metallica concert actually went to the Monsters of Rock. 1988, I think it was. I forget who was headlining, but Metallica was there, and that was my first metal concert. I was like, that was awesome. Saw Metallica there. I saw Metallica on the Justice tour. That was awesome. But then they released the Black album, and I was just like, man, what is this shit? This pop rock stuff, man. And then they released Load, and they started becoming country rock or whatever. Well, I don't even know who they are today. They should have changed their name from Metallica to, like, Smurfalica or something. I don't know. But, and I can understand, you know, they're getting older, and maybe they're getting a little more mellow, and James is trying to sing, protect, you know, preserve his vocals. But Metallica was, and for me, will always be, Justice for All, Ride the Lightning, and Master of Puppets. Just not a big fan of everything else. But, you know, like I said, but then I found, to me, the person that's even higher than Metallica, King Diamond and Mercyful Fate. There was this guy who went to public school. He went to public school, high school. I forget how I ran into him. I kind of knew him a little bit. We would cross paths, me and our friends, once in a while, and he turned me on. I forget where we were. I had a boombox back then. I had this big-ass fucking black boombox. I used to paint the logos. I forget where. Was it Whiteout? What the hell I painted? I don't know if I had paint marker. I would paint the logos all over this boombox I had. And I would blast metal music down the alleys in the neighborhoods that I would go through when I go to hang out with my friends. This guy, you know, heard this music I was playing. He's like, dude, you gotta check this out. He's like, and I don't know if he lent me the Mercyful Fate. He told me about it, or he gave me the CD. And I was like, wow, what is this? This guy singing with these high vocals. He sounds like a girl, man. And I was like, I can't process this. The music was kick-ass, man. And he was singing about Satan and all this. And that was a very dark point in my life. Emotional turmoil, whatever. A very black part of my life when I found out about this stuff. And it wasn't... Yeah, I don't get into all that. But, it's kind of strange because, it's just kind of fitting. Anyway, so I found out, you know, about Mercyful Fate and King Diamond, man. I was like, this right here, man, this is what it's all about. Here's this guy, these amazing fucking vocals, just building it out, writing about this amazing stuff. It's crazy. It's not crazy, but it's just stuff I haven't really heard of before. And so inspiring because, it's just, that's what art is, man. He's just an amazing artist. And it's not the beer talking either. This guy is King Diamond. I don't even know his real name. I should know his real name. Huge fan. I've never seen him live, man. I feel so ashamed and so embarrassed. I've never seen King Diamond or Mercyful Fate live. Or Tool. Or Pink Floyd. And they are like the pinnacle of music to me. Pink Floyd, King Diamond, and Tool. And I've not seen any of them live. But I love them. And I found out about King Diamond and Mercyful Fate. I love the Mercyful Fate. Melissa, that's my favorite album of his. Along with Abigail, the Abigail album. Those two are just amazing. And then from there, you know, I delve into various music, and then, Nine Inch Nails, you know, Pantera. I didn't get into Pantera until much later in life. My late 20s. They've been out for a while already. And then I'm probably missing some bands here. Overkill. I remember there used to be this big battle about Overkill, the lead guitarist, compared to James Hetfield. There's always this weird comparison. You know, Overkill is better, and he's a better vocalist and singer than James Hetfield. I don't know all this stuff. Now, Megadeth, of course. Megadeth was good. I'm not too keen on his vocals. Not every song was kick-ass. Of course, the best album was Peace Sells. I'm not really too much of a fan of all the other albums, unfortunately. But, you know, much respect. And so that was, my very first concert was Bon Jovi, believe it or not. And that was an amazing album. The Shot Through the Heart album. I love that album. That's a really good album. I'll give credit what credit's due. As much as I hate Bon Jovi, that was an amazing album. Shot Through the Heart. That was a great concert. Cinderella opened up. And there was me, hardcore metal guy. I never went into the pits because I was a skinny guy. There was my best friend, and he was more of a Bon Jovi, Dokken, Motley Crue kind of guy. He liked Metallica, but he wasn't as hardcore as I was. And I could never understand that. I was like, dude, man, Dokken are such pussies, man. Dokken and, you know, all this other stuff, right? And I would give him a hard time. But, what he liked. But I never could stand Dokken and Motley Crue and all those bands, man. I couldn't get into them. The music was, you know, they had their catchy songs, but to me, it was Slayer, man. It was Metallica. It was, you know, Anthrax, man. Anthrax, Indians. I love that, man. That whole Among the Living. I think it was Among the Living. Is that the name of the album? Amazing album. That's the only album I like of them, too. I've heard their other stuff, but that's, for me, that's their favorite. My favorite. Death. I never really got into the death metal vocals too much, so didn't really do it for me so much. SOD, Speak English or Die. Man, I never really got into punk either. I never really could appreciate it back then. And I don't know. I don't know if it's just because I have a lot of angst in me or what it is. I'm not just a punk, not much of a punk guy. I don't know why, because I'm open to all kinds of music. Tori Amos, Michael Jackson. Enya? All kinds of music, you know. I like, you know, that was it, Dear Antwood, I forget how you say her name. I like Sade, is that her name? I like Madonna, you know, I like it all. I really do. Country artist, some country, I don't mind. I love classical music. You know, I love it. I really love it all. I love having open mind to everything. I just could never get into punk. I never got into Black Flag, Sex Pistols. I just never did. I don't know why. But to me, the most important musical influence came out when I was watching MTV, Headbangers Ball, I think it was. All of a sudden, this video comes on. It's this weird claymation video. And all of a sudden, you hear like that, right? This guitar. And then you hear, you know, dun-dun. And Sober, right? That's Sober, right? Am I getting my songs mixed up? I should know the difference between Sober and Prison Sex. No, Prison Sex is the one with the... Which song did I see now? Because they have both videos. Oh, I don't remember now. I saw one of them. It was either one of them. But den, that's Sober, I know that. That's Prison Sex. Okay. I think it might have been sober that I saw, but man, as soon as I saw that video and that music, I was just like, what is this? This is just fucking amazing. And Tool became my religion. And but not really my religion. Nothing could compare to them anymore, man. At that point, Metallica, the Black Album come out, I don't really remember. But at that point in my life, heavy metal wasn't really what it was anymore. To me. And then everything just became Tool. I just listened to Tool. And then, again, I never saw them in concert, and I want to the next time they come out. I'm going to. I've got to make it my life's goal to see them in, because Maynard is just an amazing artist. I mean, all the members of the band are, but, you know, we all know who Maynard is. He just seems like this amazing guy. Really smart, you know, talented, and but to me, it's the intelligence and his what he seems to express, his profoundness. I could just speak volumes. But I don't really read every article that he's been in and things like that. And then I also found out about Otep, this amazing woman. Is it Shamaya Otep? I think she changed her name too. She's an amazing artist. She's a woman. She's just amazing. Passionate person. Pretty cool. And then I found out about Tori Amos. Amazing again. Forgive me my allergies here. Huge Pink Floyd The Wall fan. Pink Floyd The Wall to me is just so emotionally heavy and emotionally charged. I can't listen to that album all the time because it really just mellows me out and almost puts me in a very melancholy, borderline depression, because it's just so, I can just relate to that album. It just, you know, I can just relate to that album. And it's just a beautiful album. You know, everybody likes to rave about Dark Side of the Moon. To me, it's The Wall. Then I found out lately, over this last couple years, I found about Gojira. Gojira. I'm not into the death metal, but these guys aren't really death metal. They kind of sing about nature and philosophy. Not philosophy, what do I want to say? Spirituality. A little bit. They touch on some different themes. They're not just about. They're borderline politically charged without being politically charged. They're, you know, pro-environment. They seem like smart guys. Just amazing, amazing guitar work. It's all that, like, I don't know, what is it? Is it that it's all like time signatures and stuff? Kind of like Meshuggah. Meshuggah is great stuff. Meshuggah can be a little too much for me just because it's a constant battery. Oral assault. And they can be a little too much. I need a break from them. Gojira, they have a nice mix. I love their stuff. And I found about them, I've never seen them live. And I forget how I found out about them. That's who I really listen to now. There's another great band called Goblin Cock. I forget the guy's name. But they had this good album. I can't remember the name of the album. But it's got Snuffleupagus on it. a song about them is got, oh my god, I'm having a massive brain fart right now. But good stuff by that band. It's actually one guy that kind of is the main guy behind that. I'm not sure there's a lot of different moving parts with the different band members there or not. And then, so that's who I really listen to anymore. Tool, Pucifer, A Perfect Circle, somewhat, but mostly Tool, and then I have Pink Floyd. This is all on my phone. I don't really have CDs anymore. I sold all my CDs. I just purchased what I purchased through Amazon's MP3 player. Otherwise, I'd be showing you my collection of CDs. But I don't really. I'm not religiously into music anymore like I was. Or movies. You know, I used to collect every cassette and CD of every band or every movie I would see in a theater or whatever I liked. I would always collect all the DVDs and with the Blu-rays, but I don't really do that anymore. I watch a movie at the theater and that's it. I don't feel the need to purchase the movie anymore. I don't know what that is. Just change of priorities, I guess. But yeah, so that's who I really listen to now. It's Tool, Pink Floyd, The Wall. That's on my phone. Pucifer, purchased a couple of those albums over the last month. And King Diamond, and Merciful Fate, and Gojira. I think I have all three there. I have three of their albums. I really can't name the albums, but Mars. Oh no, there's Mars or Sirius, something that terrible. I'm terrible. But like I said, I'm not diehard into knowing every single album name and title and all the lyrics. I used to be like that. I used to, in high school, during whatever it was, class or recess or some kind of gathering, I would be writing the lyrics to my favorite song. And I used to memorize all the lyrics too, but I'm not like that anymore. So I guess, you know, maybe it's something to do with age. But yeah, so I enjoy a wide variety of music. I've even expanded my music horizons out to world music. I like this amazing band out of, boy, Tibet. Hoon Her 2. H-U-U-N, H-U, and then T-U, U, if you look up H-U-U-N, Hun, Her, H-U-R, 2, T-U, Hun, Her, 2, I think that's how you pronounce it.
Amazing.
So, and there's another amazing band called Amethystium. Amethystium. I'm not sure who is a part of that band. If it's one person creating electronic music, it's kind of ambient electronic music, but I love it. Great stuff. I mean, there's a ton of electronic music out there too. I mean, lots of artists, of course. Dire Antwood, or however you pronounce them, I like them. I like a lot of different music, so that's it. One of these days we'll do one of these live chats and we'll talk about your favorite bands and type of music you like. Feel free to drop a comment. Let me know who you like. Don't ever be ashamed or feel funny to leave long multiple comments. I welcome those. Don't worry about what other people say or think. If you leave a comment and someone harasses you on my channel, I try to deal with those. I either remove those comments or I block those people. So I try to keep things around here nice and calm and civil. Yeah, you know, I'm a big proponent. If you have something to say and you think it's going to take you a couple of comments to say it, say it. Don't worry what anybody else is going to say. I welcome those long and lengthy. I may not be able to respond to you in a long and lengthy comment because there's a lot of people that leave me lots of messages and comments, and it's kind of hard to keep up. It takes a lot of time, but I do my best. So anyway, yeah, that's it. Feel free. And like I said, there's going to be a contest, and I'm going to try to do, I'm going to try to get around to doing some other videos, of course, some of the characters, and the next video I want to do in this fashion is movies, but of course I also want to talk about more heady subjects such as psychoactives. Haven't dedicated a video to those, to that subject entirely, and also religion, faith, spirituality, and all that. So until next time, hope you found this relaxing, and I appreciate everyone's comments, your suggestions, your constructive criticism, your support, your subscriptions, everyone who's been subscribing. Thank you to each one of you. And until next time, stay well, but most importantly, tingle on. Tingle on.